tardiness.
We have a light agenda today. First, this is our committee meeting, 5:30, our regularly scheduled council meeting. First item on the agenda is to receive information, take desired action regarding various boards and commissions. First is Board of Appeals. We need a replacement for Shannon Gere, Jones. Next, we have Lakewood Hill Special Tax.
Mr. Chairman, at this time, I'd like to waive rules and appoint Ms. Paulette S. Becker, and I'd also like to waive rules and appoint Mr. Frederick T. Panetti.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, passes. Next, we have third item, receive information, take desired action regarding appointment of hospital trustees.
Mr. Chairman, I move to approve first reading.
And a motion.
Second.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, passes. Next, we have our committee. We have Economic Improvement and Development. Our Honorable Chairman, Michael Brown, James Hall, member. Mr. Brent.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have two company items before us, basically, and three actual total items. The first, we have a request to adopt a resolution providing that certain conditions, under certain conditions, Spartanburg County will enter into an agreement pursuant to Title 12, Chapter 44 of the Code of Laws of South Carolina, Eaton Corporation. Mr. Carter Smith is before us, and I think he'd like to introduce the gentleman from Eaton.
Yep, very much. Thank you. Thank you, Councilman Brett. We do have several guests here with Eaton Corp today. We have Mr. Don Davis, who's heads up their property tax division there, visiting with us. Also, Kevin Cosgrove, who is the local site manager. And we also have their legal assistant, Mr. Charles Burton, here. So we appreciate y'all's consideration of their request.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. Thank you all for coming. And we appreciate you making the investment in Spartanburg County initially, and most importantly, the expansion that y'all are looking at. Do I hear a motion that we adopt the resolution?
So moved.
Motion made.
Second.
Second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. The second item still relates to Eaton Corporation. Do I hear a motion of approval first reading, the execution and delivery of fee agreement between Spartanburg County and Eaton Corporation?
So moved.
Motion made.
Second.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. And the last item is a request to adopt a resolution so as to allow investment expenditures incurred by Spartanburg Rehabilitation Institute, Inc., including its affiliated and related entities, to qualify as expenditures eligible for a fee in lieu of tax agreement with Spartanburg County to provide for the inclusion of the company into a multi-county industrial park or business park, and to commit to enter into a necessary agreements with the company to affect the intent of this resolution and other matters related to. And this is Ernest Healthcare looking to put a facility out on, I guess, number 9, and y'all know the facility. Do I hear a motion to approve the resolution?
So moved.
Motion been made and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We'll recommend to full council all three of these items. Mr. Chairman, that concludes our committee report.
Well, will that allow these, do they need to remain to 5:30 meeting real quick?
Any council members have any problems with the corporation? We thank you for coming.
Just wanted to double check. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. You'll have a good evening.
Okay. No items under public health. No items under personal finance. We do have a little Roger Nutt, Chairman, James Brett, member, Michael Brown, member.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I'd like to recognize, we've got Representative Bill Chumley here. I'd like to recognize him. Thank you for being here. Also, see our auditor, Ms. West, there, too, as well. Today, we've got before us Mr. Jim Campbell, who's our interim parks director. He's going to come to us and give us a little brief update of our the Spartanburg Parks and Rec Department. And Mr. Campbell, if you would, and while you're coming up, I'd just like to say a personal thank you for going around. I know you and Marcia have been going around to each council member and getting feedback and direction from council, and we certainly do appreciate that. It's a great great thing in the spirit of communication, both from and to. So we certainly do appreciate that, and Steve, your update.
Hey, thank you, sir. It's been a very valuable thing to us, too, because one of the most important things that one needs to do as a public servant is ascertain the desires and needs of the folks that you're trying to serve. And one of the most important publics that we serve as a staff of Spartanburg County is the Spartanburg County Council. Briefly, what we've been doing a lot of for the past month, listening and listening some more. There's a lot of good ideas that circulate among the Spartanburg Park staff, and we've been taking note of those ideas, and I've said to several of you that we've met with so far, I'm not taking credit for these ideas. I'm trying to give credit for the ideas to the people who brought them up. My primary role in all this is to string them together into understandable sentences and get them to y'all. We've engaged in a little bit of problem solving and work task priority setting, but probably the most important thing we've been trying to do is to try to figure out who we are and where we're going. On the 14th of June, we had what I called a mini retreat. We met for about 3 hours down in Cleveland Park. And our purpose was to assess where we are, where we need to be, and how we're going to get there. And let me share with you the statement that we came up with on where we need to be. Spartanburg Parks must become a trusted partner working with other public and private organizations in projects, programs, and services that improve the quality of life for Spartanburg residents and contributes to the economic success of Spartanburg County. Our resources will be constrained for the foreseeable future, so therefore we must focus on doing what we do best while helping others do what they do best. Our mission, we believe, is roughly twofold. Number one, to develop, maintain, and manage parks, and number two, to promote active lifestyles. We put this work plan together, which runs to about, I'm sorry, Mr. Breed, about 14 pages. And for many of you, I have cut it down to about 5 pages, which will wind up becoming the mechanism by which we report to the county administrator on an ongoing basis. We have had at this moment 4 meetings with county council members, and we'll be having another one tomorrow. I hope to finish that out by the week's end. And I want to tell you that this work plan will also always be a work in progress. As new opportunities come up, we'll adjust, and we will use it as a mechanism for communicating back with y'all on those alterations that have to come up. We've been trying to remake the work environment a bit, emphasizing public service and partnership. People are getting tired of saying partnership, but we're going to have to beat that drum a great deal. We're trying to promote teamwork wherever we can, empower staff wherever we can. Mr. Breed and Mr. Hip have approved a slight staff realignment, which we'll be briefing our staff on Wednesday. And we've gone out of the way to build a closer working relationship with other county departments. In terms of partnerships so far, they've reached out to us, the Palmetto Conservation Foundation, the Convention and Visitors Bureau, the Chamber of Commerce, the Tiger River Foundation, Partners for Active Living, the Carolina Football Club, the Town of Reedville, and there's a lot more on our list. There's a lot of organizations with whom we share common goals and common opportunities. And we feel like if we can work together with those organizations, we can do a better job overall for Spartanburg County. Everyone, of course, is interested in Tiger River Park and how we're going to finish that. I have done a recommendation that, again, I'm sorry, Mr. Brady, is 13 pages long and covers the entire history of the Tiger River Park project and makes certain recommendations as to funding. We'll be bringing that to y'all at the August meeting. And last, this is my promise to y'all, and it's a personal goal of mine. We've got to remain in alignment. The park staff, county administration, and county council have got to be on the same page. So I'd ask y'all, if you see us getting off that page, please tell us. If I see y'all going in a direction that doesn't seem to be on the same page, I'll respectfully raise my hand and say, can we talk about it? So I'll be happy to try to answer any questions.
Thank you, Jim. Any questions?
I just appreciate the time that y'all spent with me last week, and I'm excited about what's going on.
Okay. Thank you, Jim. I appreciate it. That's all we have, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Nutt. The item is under public safety, the item is under land use, the item is under public works. That concludes our committee meeting. Again, I apologize for our tardiness.